Hey guys, it's Greg. How's it going today? In this video, I want to cover how to really nail your next data science interview. So number one, you have to know your SQL and database skills. I know people have said this before, but seriously, it is very, very unlikely that you don't get asked some sort of SQL or database-like question. Make sure you know how to pull data from one or two tables, merge them together so you can get the results that you want, preferably both with a subquery and with a join. And if you can get to bigger and bigger databases, like multiple tables, and just get practicing moving data around, getting what you want, you are going to do much better in interviews right away. Okay, so number one, definitely nail those SQL skills. Now, number two, some people may not recommend this one, but I really strongly do, is anything that you can do in SQL, try to do that in Python, and not necessarily base Python, probably Pandas or PySpark or both. So all of those relational database skills, you know, I would actually learn the SQL commands, specifically how to get those, but then also do that in Pandas and PySpark or whatever Python libraries, or R if you like R, but I'm a Python fanboy given by the hat. All of that stuff that you can do in SQL, I would do that in Python as well. As well as, yes, you guessed it, LeetCode style questions, okay? I know they're annoying, a lot of people don't like them, but it is reality that these questions are still being asked, you know, competitive programming, HackerRank, whatever you want to call these types of questions, data structures and algorithm stuff. So make sure that you know your data structures and algorithms, hash maps, dictionaries. I know they're basically the same thing, but hash maps, dictionaries, breadth first and depth first search, you know, strings, all of that stuff. I'm not going to list it all right now, but I think you get the idea. Data structures and algorithms types questions are asked all the time in data science interviews. I know it's a little bit counterintuitive. Data science is more mathy, more analytics, statistics, machine learning. I'll get to machine learning soon. But these LeetCode style questions are asked all the time, especially as some of the early round stuff where even before you get to the machine learning based questions, they just judge if you can program in general, especially the FANG level companies. You know, I was about to say Microsoft. Technically, they're not part of FANG. They really should be. Microsoft, Netflix, even though Netflix's stock has gone way down. Facebook, even though their stock has also gone way down. Google, Amazon, you name it. All of these really big companies, they 100% ask the very difficult, occasionally very difficult, LeetCode style questions. And pretty much every company will ask some sort of beginner to intermediate question. And it getting more and more difficult the higher up companies that you try to attack. I would probably move now, if you think you've got that stuff covered, to the data science and analytics questions. So definitely for data science, you're going to be asked machine learning type questions. So like, what is the bias variance trade-off, underfitting and overfitting, just training models in general, like cross-validation and other ways to train models and evaluate models. Maybe different loss functions and error functions for measuring the performance of these models. You know, anything about training models is definitely fair game. Regarding these specific models, I know a lot of people, at least I get asked this question a lot, which is like, which models do you have to know to pass these machine learning interviews? That is a tricky question, but most of the time, it is true that you should know linear regression and logistic regression really, really well. Definitely the difference between regression and classification. Logistic regression by heart is for doing classification 99% of the time. And so you need to know the difference between those. Actually, how linear regression and logistic regression works is very, very beneficial. And regarding the tree-based algorithms, so the tree family, which is, you know, well, trees in general, we have like AttaBoost, forgetting the name, you know, random forest, gradient boost, XGBoost, those types of tree-based models. I would recommend learning them. It maybe isn't super strictly necessary, but if you can learn them, I think people would be very appreciative of that. And, you know, they are very commonly used in companies, especially stuff like XGBoost. Those really complicated tree-based models are very common for sure. Deep learning questions are very, very common. So how neural networks work, what they do, what they can be used for, you know, the basic architectures like feed-forward nets, as well as the more complicated and and specific ones, convolutional nets, recurrent nets, and how they've gotten, you know, they've changed over time to address various issues. All about how these things learn, what they can do in particular, how they work is really, really beneficial. Definitely understanding the graphs for deep learning. So there's some really basic ones, but you need to make sure that you know them. So like how the loss function should go down. If the loss function is, you know, not going down, it's going up, that's definitely an issue. They may ask you questions related to that. And what's going on in this graph? What's going on in this loss function? How is it training? Maybe why isn't it working? What could we do better? That type of thing. So for that, I would definitely recommend, you know, both doing that in theory and practice, although I'll say in a moment how I'd actually prepare for these things. So neural network type questions all over the place, as advanced as you can possibly get to, you know, like object detection algorithms, like transformers, really state-of-the-art stuff, generative adversarial networks, all not necessarily fair game, but would be very, very beneficial for you to answer these questions. If they come up, you will be the person that, you know, gets that extra mile. There was many times a couple years ago where I was the person that kind of went the extra mile in researching and understanding these complicated things. A lot of other people and candidates, they had good credentials, but they just didn't understand this stuff as well as I did. And I think that really helped me get some of the internships that I did. Although I haven't really said the word, I've been referring here to supervised learning algorithms, so that do regression or classification through, you know, training data, and they learn how to function and how to spit out an answer given an input. Regarding the unsupervised family, so say clustering, dimensionality reduction, recommender systems, stuff like that, most of the time you probably don't need to know it as well, although I would definitely know the common clustering algorithms like dbScan and k-means. Past that, you know, I think that's probably good for most circumstances, but as far as you want to go into that, by all means. Regarding recommender systems, they're very beneficial if you are going into a company that has a recommender system. Pretty much all of the big companies do, and so I would recommend learning the basics at least of how those work, and as far as you can possibly get into understanding the more complex ones, they will greatly appreciate. And it's one of the most common roles they hire for is improving and changing their recommender systems, so that would be really helpful as well in some circumstances. For many jobs, it's really not necessary at all, but for some, it's really, really beneficial. Okay, moving away from machine learning, I would certainly know how confidence intervals and hypothesis testing work, also A-B testing, not really too much difference there, but those fundamental concepts, really, really important. Of course, stuff like average and standard deviation / variance of populations is kind of fundamental, but make sure that you can understand those pretty well. Regarding the probability distributions, so Bernoulli, you know, binomial, exponential, Poisson, all of that family of stuff, I would probably be aware of their existence and understand like the complete basics of what's going on there. But for the vast majority of jobs, you pretty much need to know the one that I haven't said, the normal distribution. Make sure you know how that one works, and what it's, you know, what it can do, what it's talking about, the random variable math behind it. And honestly, past that, I wouldn't worry too much for the majority of jobs. Confidence intervals and hypothesis testing for normal distributions, and by extension, the t-distribution, is very, very good. Learning all of those mini distributions, not really too good use of your time, but it would be sort of helpful, I guess. Regarding the probability type questions, I wouldn't really worry too much about them for now. If you do find that that's the limiting factor for you and that you keep getting asked them and you keep getting walled by them and they're turning you down, then sure, I would maybe learn about it then. But for now, I would not really worry about it too much. Some simple ideas that, you know, may be beneficial in every now and then would be Bayes' rule, simple probability counting arguments, like combinations and permutations. Past some simple counting and probability arguments, I would not put too much focus into it until you get walled by it that many times. The majority of companies are probably not going to be asking these types of questions. Some of them will. Some of them kind of claim they will, and then it's more so just a confidence interval or hypothesis testing type question, and usually not so much into the actual probability. Sometimes there is, but most of the time it's not. So those are really the different types of questions that you get asked. We talked at the beginning about databases and SQL, so different queries on how to grab data and manipulate it right, and then about how to do that with Python for extra practice with Python, pandas, and SQL as well. And then definitely LeetCode style questions, data structures and algorithms, make sure you know that stuff. And then into the more machine learning and data science stuff, definitely machine learning models, common ones like linear regression, logistic regression, how to train models, get into deep learning if you can, and if that's the type of job there is. To be honest, even if they haven't mentioned deep learning, I would learn it as much as you can. And then finally, confidence intervals and hypothesis testing and simple probability arguments. I believe this set of stuff will get you a long way. And then maybe when you go to interview for yourself, you'll figure out the limiting factors of yourself, and then you can pick and choose what you want to upgrade at that point. If you want to learn this stuff, I very strongly recommend the pathway that I have in the description of this video. Take a look at that, and if you are a beginner, you can follow that all the way through and learn pretty much everything there, as well as extra skills that have, you know, a ton of value for improving your resume and your skill set, even if you might not talk about them as commonly in interviews. For example, MLOps, like deploying models, you might not talk about your Flask and Django skills. Maybe you will, maybe you won't, but they're very beneficial to have as well. So I would definitely recommend following that pathway. If you are not a beginner, then go ahead and not follow the pathway, but pick and choose the pieces of that pathway that you want to further improve your skill set in. See what you're missing. Maybe I talked about something in this video that you think you're missing, and you'll probably find it somewhere in that pathway. In addition, for practicing these things, I would definitely recommend LeetCode as a free platform for the programming questions, as well as the SQL questions. And for the machine learning style ones, we have Kaggle for solving different machine learning problems. For the confidence intervals and also probability questions, there isn't really any good sites I would really, really strongly recommend. But if you search online, probability questions, confidence interval, and hypothesis testing questions, you will get a ton of results and you can practice them there. Finally, some general tips to really help in whatever interview you're trying to do. I'm going to sound like a broken record along with the rest of the world, but it is so true. You have to be an excellent communicator. And I know that for many of you, that is going to be the factor that is most difficult. Sometimes it's a language barrier. Sometimes it's just a confidence barrier, and maybe both intertwined. Whatever it is, practice speaking in front of a camera with a microphone and recording yourself and reciting all of the things that you know. So your resume, like all of the projects that you've worked on, any of your experiences at work or school or whatever it may be, any of the things that you may talk about or may want to talk about in an interview, make sure you've practiced those things and you can recite them in a way that makes sense. Recite them properly. Convey it with kindness and excitement, and you are a million times more likely to get the job than all of the other people that have awesome technical skills but just aren't able to convey it in the way that you want to. A final reminder, make sure that you've got your SQL skills down. You almost certainly will be asked this type of question, and even if you don't, that skill is extremely important, so practice that a lot. As a recap, the things that you need to know, SQL and programming style questions come up all the time, machine learning and model training like questions, confidence intervals and hypothesis testing, a little bit about probability, but maybe not too much, and that is really the main technical set of skills that you're going to be asked. Another freaking reminder, SQL, just learn it really well. It's going to help a lot. To learn these things, I would strongly recommend the pathway that I have in the video description, and to practice those things, LeetCode, HackerRank as well for programming, Kaggle, and online resources you can search out are really awesome as well. Okay, guys, I wish you the best of luck in your data science interviews. I hope that helped. I have everything in the description of the video. I also included how I would apply to these data science jobs as well. If you haven't seen that video, I would check that out as well. Have a great day, and I'll see you later. I wish you the best of luck. Seriously, try as hard as you can, and you will get this. I promise you. See you guys.